Hello everyone, Harry here, welcome to Scrap Science. Today, I feel like I've been doing some very time-consuming projects for Scrap Science lately. And while I very much enjoy making those videos, I feel like I deserve to be able to make, once in a while, something like this. A short, kind of stupid video where we just kind of, I don't know, build something simple. So today, that's exactly what we're doing. A few years ago, I don't remember exactly when, I learned of the concept of a magnetohydrodynamic drive. And as futuristic as it sounds, it's really quite simple, right? All it involves is passing an electric current through a conductive fluid, and then if that fluid is under the influence of a magnetic field, you will get the Lorentz force on that fluid, pushing it perpendicular to the direction of flow of current and the direction of the magnetic field lines, using like the right-hand rule, if that's the one you learned in high school like I did. Anyway, the exact details don't matter. If we pass an electric current through a conductive fluid and we have magnets around that oriented in the right way, we will effectively get movement of that fluid. Now, as you may be aware, I'm rather experienced in putting current through conductive solutions. I thought to myself, why don't we make one of these things? It can't be that hard. And on further thinking, I thought, why don't we make it into an item that actually does something? So that's what I've built today. What I've got here is a 3D printed boat of sorts, right? This is equipped with a magnetohydrodynamic drive on the bottom. I hate calling it that. That sounds like a stupid name to me. Basically, if this sits in a conductive solution and we pass current in the right way, on the bottom here, we will get movement of the conductive solution, the fluid, either backwards or forwards, depending on which way I've oriented these magnets. And since the magnetic field is then putting a force on the conductive solution, pushing it backwards or pushing it forwards, equal and opposite forces, of course, the boat itself will move in the opposite direction. So this is effectively a toy boat that moves without, you know, a propeller or anything like that. There are no moving parts on this toy boat. Again, it really is super simple. I've just sticky taped some magnets all in the same orientation. So either this is north, north, and north, or it's south, south, and south. I can't actually tell. And then there are these two graphite rods that sit on either side of them. Current will pass through our conductive solution in between them, and the whole Lorentz force thing will happen on top of these magnets. I've got some titanium connections over here that just kind of clamp onto the graphite rods so that we can sit a battery pack in here and make some connections to our graphite. I'm thinking a 6-volt battery pack with just 4 AA batteries should be enough to get some movement. So here I have a plastic tub of water that I added a whole bunch of salt to earlier. The salt, of course, makes the solution conductive, and we can, of course, now pass current through it and actually achieve that Lorentz force that we want. Since we're using table salt, sodium chloride, as our electrolyte here, this is the reason I'm using titanium and graphite rods. A lot of other metals, like stainless steel, nickel, copper, all of these things, when used as the positive electrode, will dissolve into solution, and that's not really a nice thing to have when we're just trying to build a toy boat. Since we have inert electrodes, we will probably generate a little bit of chlorine on the positive electrode, but it'll be a small amount, and a small amount of chlorine never hurt anyone, is what I say. So I've got all the connections made. I've got the battery pack on the boat. We've made our connections to the two graphite rods. The real question is, if I drop this into the middle of our solution, will it move? And if it does move, which way will it move? I've got no idea. I mean, it moves. It's very slow. but it does move. It's always in a consistent direction as well. Let's spin it around just to show that. Don't sink. So now it should hopefully move to the left. Yeah, it's going. And yeah, it works. Doesn't work well, but it works. The boat moves. We built a toy boat with no moving parts that will kind of propel itself forward in conductive water. I'm afraid that's all you're getting from me today. That's the whole video. I promise my next one will be better. See you later.